there's definitely much more mystery surrounding why he went to North Korea. We had been told that when he arrived in North Korea, he tore up his visa and was seeking asylum there in North Korea, but we don't really know why that was the case. Again, we know that he went before a court there, and he was convicted of hostile acts against the government of North Korea. I can tell you that the AP and that's the Associated Press and a South Korean newspaper who had listened into his trial just within the last couple of months, they reported that the government had alleged that he had wanted to come to North Korea and to actually break the law so that he would be thrown into prison in order to be a witness to the human rights concerns in that country. So that is the story about Matthew Todd Miller. But again, the truth is still very murky in all of that. And his family has been very quiet throughout this time, unlike the family of Kenneth Bae, who's been very outspoken in trying to get his release. Of course, every family handles situations differently. And so Matthew Todd Miller's family has chosen to be a little bit more private, as we've also seen here today, and that they want to keep this as a family affair. So obviously he did ask for his release when Will Ripley went and had a chance to speak with him. And so I'm sure he and his family are extremely grateful for this opportunity to be back in the U.S. and to reunite.